What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's time for another video. We are coming today from Daniel chapter 3. We're speaking on boldness in the Holy Spirit part 2. The Lord put this in my spirit to continue, so we're going to continue. Daniel chapter 3, we're going to start at verse 4. And we're going to go through, and this story is about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And I want you all to understand that this is what God is desiring from us, to be bold no matter what, to speak His word no matter what, never to back down or bow down to the image of what this world is producing, the culture of this world is producing. So we're going to get right into it. Daniel chapter 3, verse 4. Then a herald cry aloud to you, "It is commanded, O people, nations, and languages, that at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar king hath set up. And whoso falleth not down and worshipeth shall the same hour be cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace." So this is speaking of the commandment on which King Nebuchadnezzar had made in the land, in which dwelt three spirit-led, full of God, young people: Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now, I want you all to understand boldness in the Holy Spirit. You don't bow down to the image. I want you all to understand that in everything that you do, it is a form of worship. Where your mind is set, the thoughts that you have, it is a form of worship. If you raise your hands or dance to certain music, it is a form of worship. The meditation of your heart, what you meditate on all day, is a form of worship. The world wants to make worship money, lust, sex, or use lust, and drama. And when I say drama, I mean watching and being involved in drama. It's a form of worship. All of these things are a form of worship. If you raise your hands, dance, or play, or sing certain types of music, that's a form of worship. That's why it's important that we separate ourselves from secular music and listen to godly music and worship the Lord. That way our mind and our hearts and our meditation stays on the Lord. So we're going to skip down to verse 8. And it says, "Wherefore, at that time, certain Chaldeans came near and accused the Jews. They spake and said to the king Nebuchadnezzar, O king, live forever. Thou, O king, hast made a decree that every man that shall hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and dulcimer, and all kinds of music shall fall down and worship the golden image. And whoso falleth not down and worshipeth, that he should be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. There are certain Jews whom thou hast set over the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have not regarded thee. They serve not thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up." Then Nebuchadnezzar, in his rage and fury, commanded to bring Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Then they brought these men before the king. Nebuchadnezzar spake and said unto them, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Do not ye serve my gods, nor worship the golden image which I have set up? Now, if ye be ready, that at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the image which I have made, well. But if ye worship not, ye shall be cast the same hour into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. And who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hands? I want you all to get this, ladies and gentlemen. Because he has not seen the manifestation of the true God whom we serve, he said in himself, what God can deliver you out of my hands? Because the gods that they serve and the witchcraft that they were involved in or that they do, they haven't seen deliverance in that manner, or they haven't seen people being set free or delivered from them or him being king or kings at that time, because they feel like they have all authority, they have all power, they have all control. But our God is a God that sets them in place, that he may display his power, his anointing, and himself even the more so, especially when they become prideful like that. He was a prideful king, Nebuchadnezzar. And if you go and study the book of Daniel, you'll see a lot of things concerning different kings. So we're going to continue. Now, this is the response of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in verse 16, 17, and 18. So you're going to see where the boldness of the Holy Spirit comes in this right here. So verse 16, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. So they're saying, King, we don't even have to take a second thought about it. We already know what the deal is. Verse 17, if it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O King. But if not, be it known unto thee, O King, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Now I want you all to hear this. Now in the New Testament, in Hebrews 11 and 6, it says, but without faith it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. So they said to the king, our God, in verse 17, if it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from thine hand, O King. So they said he is, and we know that it says they must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder. They already believe that he is because they said he is able. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said he is able to deliver us out of thy hand, O King, because the king asked, who can deliver you out of my hand? And that's how we should feel when it comes to the world we live in now. When they say, who can deliver you from being put in jail for preaching the gospel, or from being killed for preaching the gospel, or persecution is a part of it. So persecution, that's nothing. Let people talk, because then more people will watch your life. And as long as you're living holy, that's a good thing. Because as they watch your life and they follow you, they'll say, well, it is something different about this person. And they'll see your boldness in God. And that'll draw more people to Christ. Because Jesus said in John 12:32, and I, if I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all men unto me. So if you have faith in the God that you serve, that boldness in God, then, and in the Holy Spirit, which the Holy Spirit does give, then you don't have to worry. That's why they said, we're not careful to answer thee, O King, because we know our God is able. I believe my God is able to deliver. I believe my God is able to bless. And that's why I do not waver. And this is what the Lord wants me to get across to you all, not to waver in your method of thinking. Study God's word. Every answer you need is right here. Don't waver because somebody says they're going to send you before the judge or before the king. Jesus already said it, and I think I explained it to you all in the first video about the boldness in the Holy Spirit, but Jesus already said they're going to bring you before kings and governors for my sake. So don't be afraid, but we're going to continue here because I want you all to see the outcome of this. So verse 19, then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his visage was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spake and commanded that they should heat the furnace one 7 times more than it was wont to be heated. And he commanded the most mighty men that were in his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Then these men were bound in their coats, their hose, their hats, and their other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. So you see that they were taken in because the king got upset because he had never seen the true God whom we serve deliver, but he's about to see it now. Verse 22, therefore, because the king's commandment was urgent and the furnace exceeding hot, the flames of the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. This right here lets you know that they were delivered, because the Bible says that they fell down bound, where it says that the men that served King Nebuchadnezzar, were slew, which means they were killed, they were burned alive. Verse 24, then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished and rose up in haste and spake and said unto his council, did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, O king, true, O king. Verse 25, he answered and said, lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. God is going to get his glory regardless of what people say, regardless of what people do. If you're living a lifestyle pleasing unto the Lord, he is going to get his glory. And for those of you who are not, who may watch this video, he's still going to get his glory, because in the end, all that he spoke in the Bible is true. So the king said in verse 25, and the fourth is like the Son of God. Verse 26, then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come hither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth, forth out of the midst of the fire, and the princes, governors and captains, and the king's counselors, being gathered together, saw these men upon whose bodies the fire had no power, nor was a hair of their head singed, neither were their coats changed, nor the smell of fire had passed on them. Oh my goodness, Holy Spirit, I want you all to understand this. I really want you all to get this. The Spirit of the Lord will be so heavy upon you that no matter what people do, nothing can happen to you unless God allows it to happen. But they already had faith because they had already spoken. Jesus, help me get this out. They had already spoken and said, King, our God shall deliver us. Regardless of what you do, our God shall deliver us. And even if he chooses not to, we're still not going to bow down and worship the image. I want you all to understand that being bold in God, you have to take that stand that I am still not, regardless of what the rest of the world is doing, I shall not bow down and worship the image. Whew, I feel the Holy Ghost. I want to go to, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, Lord Jesus, help me get this out, please. We're going to skip to verse 29 really quickly. I want you all to hear what the king said. Therefore, I made a decree that every people, nation, and language which speak anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut up in pieces, and their houses shall be made a dunghill, because there is no other God that can deliver after this sort. Now I want you all to understand that when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, thank you, Holy Spirit, when they spoke to the king and said, King, we're not careful to answer thee in this matter, I believe that they had studied the words of Isaiah in Isaiah 33:22, because it says in Isaiah 33:22, for the Lord is our judge, the Lord is our lawgiver, the Lord is our king, he will save us. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that they knew that in their hearts. I believe all of them studied that, and I believe they may have even written that on their heart, because they they knew that God would deliver and that God would save them. Ladies and gentlemen, I love you all. I'm sorry it was a little bit long, but when it comes to ministering the gospel and speaking the word of God, I get joy, especially in knowing that our God is able, that our God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. So I just want you all to be bold in the Spirit of God, and we're going to continue. There's going to be a part three, because there's another story in Daniel, and the next story is speaking on Daniel, as a matter of fact. And then there are stories in the New Testament, which I'm going to try to put into play as we continue on. Ladies and gentlemen, I pray that you're blessed by this. I pray that those of you who are watching have subscribed, but more or less that you just watch and continue to give God the glory, and that you grow and that you're strengthened in the Lord. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless.